Is Meghan the new Diana? That's the question gripping India's press after the discovery of a picture of the Duchess of Sussex. The image of Meghan in a sari and wearing a bindi on her forehead echoes photos of Diana wearing a bindi in India in 1992. Meghan was visiting a Mumbai women's charity, the Meena Mahila Foundation, in January 2017. She proved her commitment to the charity by inviting four of its female organizers, including founder Suhani Jalota, to her wedding. Meena, which provides sanitary products for women in India and tackles taboo issues such as menstrual hygiene, was one of seven charities nominated for gift donations by the couple. Hopes are high that Meghan will return to India after she took the time at her wedding reception to promise Ms. Jalota she would give more time to Meena Mahila. I can reveal Prince Harry will play in his Centibale Polo Cup in the UK this summer. It will be at a Royal Polo Club in England, former England captain Malcolm Borwick tells me. Harry's Centibale charity supports the mental health and well-being of children affected by HIV in Lesotho and Botswana. Adorable bridesmaid Florence Van Cutsem is real-life linked to the Crown. Florence, 3, is the niece of actor Harry Haddon Payton, who plays the Queen's private secretary Martin Charteris in the series. Eagle-eyed fans of the Crown will have spotted a link with real life during the royal wedding, in the form of cute bridesmaid Florence Van Cutsem, right? Florence, 3, is the niece of actor Harry Haddon Payton, who plays the Queen's private secretary Martin Charteris in the series. Uncle Harry is Sarah Ferguson's godson and a contemporary of Prince William at Eton. His sister Alice is married to wealthy business developer Nicholas Van Cutsem, who has known William and Harry since childhood, which of course explains why their daughter Florence is Prince Harry's goddaughter. When Harry and Meghan got the chance to pick a film for Buckingham Palace staff to watch before the wedding, they knew what to choose: the story of a groundbreaking interracial royal marriage. A United Kingdom is based on the marriage of Prince Sirit Khama of Botswana and British woman Ruth Williams in 1948. Staff were told the film was picked especially by the couple for the Palace Film Club. Botswana was where Harry and Meghan spent a nature reserve holiday, while Meghan's engagement ring featured a diamond from the African state. Millie McIntosh has her own right royal hen night. You'd have thought her hens, including Lily Fortescue and health guru Madeline Shaw, could have stretched to a first-class upgrade. Before the big event, some misinformed celebrity watchers were tipping Millie McIntosh to be a bridesmaid at the royal wedding. Yet when the day arrived, she was watching it at home on TV. Could it be that Millie's more suited to the scene in this picture? Left sipping tins of gin and tonic on the train to her hen night on Friday, Millie was clad in plastic tiara and veil in a prelude to her own wedding to Met co-star Hugo Taylor next month. You'd have thought her hens, including Lily Fortescue and health guru Madeline Shaw, could have stretched to a first-class upgrade. The walk up to St. George's Chapel in Windsor was like a fashion catwalk with celebrities and socialites dripping in designer gear, but James Matthews had one unusual accessory, a BT bill. Surely the multimillionaire hedge fund manager has a direct debit for that. His excuse is that wedding guests needed to show ID, but as he's married to the future Queen's sister, he had more chance than most of being recognized by officials.